Hi there, ladies and gentlemen. This is your neighborhood friendly Octorn, and here I am today with an Echo Lake Lumber Mill efficiency settlement build. This is one of the four different settlements that come with Fallout 4's latest DLC, Far Harbor. I've done two of them. This is the third. One more to do after this. This settlement was a beast. Oh my gosh, it was a beast. But it was a heck of a lot of fun. I enjoyed every moment of it, and this has turned, I think, into one of my favorite settlements to date. So I hope you've got a few minutes to spare, because this is going to be a lot of fun. Before we begin, I just want to say that due to the nature of Far Harbor, I'm going to be using console commands to clear the weather repeatedly during the recording of this video, just so that you can see what's going on here. So first things first, let's hop into the sky and show you the bounds of this settlement. As you can see, it is an absolutely huge settlement. This is definitely one of the largest in the entire DLC, except for the possible exception of Old Longfellow's Cabin, because that's an entire island. But this is a huge area. It came with this dilapidated structure here in the middle, and one right there, and one right there, and one right there. Lots of clutter all over the place. I'm going to go ahead and show you a before shot of what this place looked like. Strewn with garbage, and rusty buildings, and rusty vehicles and broken buildings and just an absolute nasty mess. Piles of rubbish everywhere. Due to the size of this settlement, it's an excellent place if you're wanting to create a settlement that maximizes your character's charisma settler cap. So as you know, the maximum settlers you can have is based on your charisma, and those with high charisma can use settlements like this to experiment with having a lot of settlers in their settlements. Let's pop back down. All right, let's start at the beginning. So this is the entrance, and as you see, it's got this sign that says Echo Lake Lumber. I wanted to light it up at night, and so I created this platform up there, and I used the ceiling-mounted spotlights that came with Wasteland Workshop to illuminate the sign. This was pretty tricky. You can't actually put the platforms on top of the sign, so I ended up having to build a scaffolding network using the interior steps floor to get to the top, and then I used these small platforms to kind of push it on top of there, push it down, and then affix my lights to that. That's how I was able to illuminate the Echo Lake Lumber Mill. Over here we see Gracie. Gracie is a named super mutant hound that you can buy from Erickson, who is a wandering dog. No, I'm sorry, he's not a wandering dog tradesman. He's a stationary dog tradesman. I did an entire video on him, so check out my video on that for more. But I sent Gracie to this settlement, and she's guarding this settlement. By the way, she will not enter the doghouse, but she will stick close by the doghouse. And then on the entrance here, I've got these two guard towers elevated by these tall structures. I also put the Wasteland Workshop spotlight, the wall-mounted spotlight, on these things, which I think is a nice touch, but for some reason there's a bug in that if you fast travel away and then fast travel back, the light turns off. But there you go, that's all you gotta do to get it to work. So there we go, I've got the spotlights working on the outside. All right, moving on in, I'll talk about the structures in a minute, but I just want to highlight the farm and this eating area. So I struggled. Ladies and gentlemen, I struggled with what to do with the settlement because it was huge, it was so messy, and I finally decided to, as always, be utilitarian and turn this sort of driveway slash parking lot area into an outdoor restaurant, eating, patio, marketplace. So I put down 17 bars. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, 17 bars. And the reason I put down 17 bars is because I recently completed a follow-up to my happiness experiment, where I finally deconstructed how happiness works in settlements. So now I can predict with 100% accuracy exactly what my target happiness will be if I make certain changes. And I did the math and I figured out that for settlements of my size, with 36 settlers, because based on my charisma, I always try to make settlements with 36 settlers, for settlements of my size, I need 17 bars to most efficiently maximize my settlement's happiness. Now, obviously, I can't do that at every settlement, but on the large ones, I can. So I did it at the visitor center, and I'm going to be doing it here. I tried to decorate it up a little bit to make it a little bit more unique instead of just having a whole bunch of bars down. I put signage out there. I placed lights on each one. And then I put down all these eating stations, complete with perfect lighting, lots of food. Each one of these tables is a different type of drinking station. There's a soda drinking station. This is a wine drinking station. This is a water drinking station for those who are teetotalers. And this is, of course, a hard liquor drinking station, followed up, finally, by a beer drinking station. Then over here, I've got the farm. This, I figured it was going to be a perfect place for it, so I set down my 72 carats. That's right, this is 72 carats exactly, because 72 divided by 2 is 36, which is the exact amount of food that I need. Carrots only provide 0.5 happiness. I'm sorry, 0.5 food. And once I got my carrot field down, I surrounded it with this chicken wire fence. I'm gonna go ahead and change the time of day so that it doesn't get dark on us. There we go. Now this is the boundary of the settlement. There's this huge sort of marketplace stall area back here, which I'm kind of bummed that I didn't get access to, because I could have seen this as being a neat, like, if I could have pushed my shops in here, this would have been really a neat place to have a marketplace. But the boundaries of the settlement end right at that, right at the edge of this arena here, and so I couldn't make use of this, but that's okay. I decided to just turn this part into my farm and this part over here into my outdoor marketplace slash restaurant. I also, there's this shack right here that's got some nice signs on it. Echolike Lumber Mill, Lumberjack Festival. So the Lumberjack Festival was going on at this lumber mill during the nuclear holocaust, when the nuclear explosion happened. And you see evidence of that later on, which I'll show you. But sadly, you can't enter this building, you can't scrap this building or do anything with it. So instead, I use this stairway over here as a smoking station. I've got a lit cigar, and I also have some animation mats set down as well. Coffee and cigars and cigarettes. You've got your coffee, cigarettes, and cigars. And then I'm using a mod to create these animation mats, and the way they work is like chairs. Settlers will walk by, and they have a random chance to sit down or to stand on top of the mat and perform the associated animation, like drinking coffee or smoking cigarettes. And it's invisible when you exit the workshop. That mod is linked in the description. So I set that down there, and then I put my defenses on top of this roof. But I'll get to defenses in a little bit. All right, let's talk about the main house, ladies and gentlemen. This house was an absolute monster. It was a beast. It was a terror and a nightmare, but it was ultimately rewarding. The original state of it was in pieces. Walls were missing, roofs were missing, floors were missing. There was garbage on the inside, tons of scrap everywhere, and the most nightmarish part of it was the roof, and I'll get to the roof later on. But let's start by going on inside and showing you what I've done with the interior here. So let's actually start at the bottom floor. There's another door out here, by this seating area. So coming on inside, you see room number one, and I've got 36 settlers, and I didn't want to use sleeping bags in such a large settlement, so I did use nice made beds. This is my only settlement with made beds, including the pillows for every single settler. I wanted these sort of dormitory-style living areas to be as customized for each settler as possible. Now, there are only two lamp choices in Wasteland Workshop. Only two working lamps, this yellow one and then a blue one that doesn't have a lampshade. So sadly, all of the lamps look the same, and of course, all of the beds look the same. But I figure, you know, that's not too unrealistic in a world where you've got settlements that each have to pool their resources. So I tried to add some individuality by each bed has their own storage container. Each settler has his or her own storage container with his or her own stuff. And then I decorated each of the side tables in a unique way with personal effects that may be important to that particular settler, just to try and make it look a little bit more like there are individual people living here. Now these shelving units came with this settlement, and this one right here, the top one, that was actually crooked. So I used my precise rotating and movement mod to twist it back up, And then I just decorated them with OC Decorator, and I think it turned out really well. It really adds some life to this area down here. The lighting was tricky. So this is such a huge building that the nodes, the electrical nodes that you can place near your house, the field of electricity that they generate do not stretch all the way through the building, which is why you see this table has a lantern and this table has a non-lit bed. These are so close to the interior of the building and the middle of the building that the electrical fields just didn't reach this far inward. So I would have had to have wired electricity through the door into this building in order to get this spot right here, which is like a dead space in the house. And then I also had to repair the walls. So check this out. This was completely blown out, and this ceiling was blown out. I used the barn walls from Wasteland Workshop. I'm sorry, from Far Harbor to patch the walls here. Look at that. Look at all of the patchwork I had to do. It was just absolutely everything. This is even bent outward. And you know, you can't scrap it, you can't remove it. It's bent outward. So I basically had to build a new house wall on the inside of this existing house wall just to make it so that there weren't huge holes in the walls of these guys' houses. All right, so that's floor one. I love the Vim poster and just the random posters on the wall. I had to cover it up a little bit because these guys needed storage. You know, there are all these different people, 36 people living in this house, and they have to have storage. But I love these posters on the wall. Moving up to floor number two, this is the main floor. You know, this floor down here was filled with shelving units, and this floor up here was filled with shelving units. So I think that this used to be a shop of some sort. I scrapped everything that I could. There was a cash register here and a cash register here. I scrapped those just because they were in the way. But I left these banisters because I just really like the banisters, and you can't build them with your workshop, so you might as well leave them. I decorated them up with candles and flowers. And then this is dormitory number two. Again, I tried to make each little living space unique, decorated in a different way, and they've all got their own storage containers. Also, this is the green room because the carpets are green, and this is the blue room because the carpets are blue, and I've got it's different for each room. By the way, I have 10 cats here in the settlement. I've already caught them and they're wandering around, so you're going to see lots of cats wandering around. And that goes back to my happiness experiment. I figured that for a settlement with 36 settlers, if I have 10 cats, that's going to give me barely 1%. Actually, I don't even think it gives me one happiness. It's less than one happiness. But it got me to my target goal. So this corner was crumpled. You can see this big pile of bricks, which you can't remove. And I repaired the hole in the wall here and the floor, decorated the walls as best as I could. And then moving on in here, this was the bathroom. As you can see, I had to place a new door frame in there to seal it off to give people some privacy. And moving on inside, the only thing that was in here was this yellow sink, a broken mirror on the wall, and a broken toilet. I scrapped the toilet and the mirror, and I replaced them with a new toilet and a new mirror. I left the sink just because I really like it, and you can't build it with your workshop, so it's unique. And that's one of the philosophies I do with my settlements. If you find something in your settlement that's completely unique that you can't get any other way, don't scrap it, build around it. And that's what I did here. I added a couple of shelving units here just to make this place look nice and cluttered. And of course, toilet paper and newspaper so that you can read your newspaper while you're using your toilet paper. This children's desk, this school desk, came with the settlement, and I didn't remove it just because I liked it there. I don't have a use for it, but it just looks really nice up against this corner. And it also came with all of these lockers. Looks like there's something in that locker. Oh, and I'm just now finding that. Check it out. I left all the lockers that are in this house, too, because there are so many people living here that I figured they're all going to need storage and places to keep their items. So I left all the lockers. All right, around the corner we go and up to the red room. You can see I've got the red carpets on the wall, on the floor there. This is the primary dormitory space. It has the room for the most number of beds. And this floor came in a really bad state. You see how I repaired the floor here? Now, this is interesting. This is a clean break. typically when I repair the floors, you see a sort of jagged edge like that because the floor is pushed directly beneath the original floor. But this one is unique because it's actually cracked and lifted up. You see this crack in the floor right there? This is the wood of the original floor lifting up. And so because of that, there was a natural plane where the old floor ended and the new floor began. But I figure in a world that's able to create walking, talking robots, I'm sure you can use a saw to cut a straight line. So I'm not too bummed about that straight line. Over here, I placed an armoire, and I was sure to decorate it with everything you need for bedtime. Pillows, alarm clocks, and all sorts of personal effects. Couple of paintings on the wall. Patching these walls was a tricky job because there's no wall you can build that's as tall as this open space. So I ended up having to do some tricky stacking. In some places, you can see that I was able to stack some of the barn walls on top of each other. And in other places right there, I actually had to use a railing, like a banister railing, to push it up in there to get it patched up. Same with over here. This was just a tricky hole to fill. But the most tricky part about this area was the roof. This was open to the elements, and it's right above my beds. And as you know, if you've watched my happiness experiment videos, if your beds are left out in the open, you actually get a happiness penalty. And so I wanted to avoid that. So I covered it up. And instead of putting a slanted roof over here, which was the way the original house was built, I instead saw this banister here, this beam, this very thick wooden beam, and I figured, well, that's going to be thick and sturdy enough to support a roof. So I used the flat roofs, and I balanced them on this beam and on the end of the old wall. And that left a small gap here. You can kind of see out. Yeah, there's a little bit of sunlight coming in if you look just right, but this was a big gap, and so I used the railing slash banister tiles to just block that up with some scrap wood. So again, each of these beds is completely unique. This one has handcuffs. I wonder what they get to at night. And then I used this cabinet came with it, but this one didn't. I added it because it matches and because it gives them more storage. And then I decorated it up with pillows and personal effects. Another thing that's really interesting is this settlement came with portrait lighthouse pictures. So in your workshop, you can build these lighthouse paintings, but they're always square. This settlement came with the lighthouse paintings, but they were rectangular. They were in the portrait shape. And I thought that was neat, and so they're unique, and you can't get them any other way, and so I kept them. And I wanted to maintain that decor decision to have these portrait-shaped pictures, and so I put up a couple of portraits in the same shape over on the wall over there. Had to completely rebuild that wall. You can see where the red ends and the brick begins. And then this lath and plaster here had huge holes in it that I had to patch up. Just a ton of patchwork to do on this particular house. Moving up to floor three, this is my maroon slash, I don't know, what color is that? Like a tan color? I don't know. But this is just a small, tiny little nook. And I was really kind of worried because at this point I had decorated three different floors and I still had to place down more beds and I didn't know if I was going to make all 36. So I was cramming them in. You notice that these guys don't have side tables. That's because I didn't have any room. But I still tried to decorate it up. Now, the thing with this house, and the thing with most houses and most settlements that you're going to find, are going to have these filth decals, and that's the only way that I can describe them. They're basically just piles of dirt and grime and filth and bricks and pieces of paper and just grossness. Now, you can't scrap them, but if you're on the PC, you can get rid of them. Now, I've developed a way to identify which ones you can get rid of and which ones you can't. So there's a command in the console called mark for delete. You can select anything, hit mark for delete, and then the next time you fast travel into the settlement, the item will be gone. Now this tactic is tricky to use because it's dangerous. You could accidentally select, I don't know, the entire house, do mark for delete, and the next time you fast travel in, it's gone, and there's no way to get it back. So you have to be careful with it. Now the way that I use it is I select a pile of filth in the console, something that I think is potentially removable, and then I use my precise movement and rotating mod to try and move it. If it moves, then I know that I have the right thing selected, and I can then use mark for delete to get rid of it. If it doesn't move, then that means that I've got the wrong thing selected, and I won't use that command accidentally. But I removed all of the filth and garbage and grime that was littering the floor here, and I put down all my beds. Here's another lighthouse. It's the exact same lighthouse that's on this wall over here. I'm not sure if that's just the previous owners of this house really loved lighthouses, or Bethesda was just a tad lazy with the paintings of this place. I don't know, but this one is square and the other one's rectangular. Anyhow, moving on into this room. So this is the office space, and this house came with this terminal. Now, it doesn't do anything. If you try and use it, it just says terminal and there's nothing in there. But I liked it because it came with this unique chair. You see that chair? That's tied to the terminal. If you move this desk or if you scrap this desk, the terminal and that chair completely disappear. And I thought it was unique and neat and interesting, and so I wanted to preserve it. So I kept it, even though it was kind of in my way, I wanted to use this for other things. I decided to keep it. I also kept the filing cabinets and the boxes filled with papers and stuff, because I figure if this is going to be an office, it needs to look looked in, so I kept that in there. And then the only things I really added is I placed down this desk right here, which is actually a scavenging station, reskinned to look like a desk. And it comes complete with a unique animation for settlers assigned to it. I put down some lamps over the desks. I decorated the walls with some posters. And that's about it. I'm using this as sort of a little storage area. And then this is my kitchen / larder. So over here is the cooking area. I've got a stove, a variety of different stoves. I've got a refrigerator and I've got this larder. Now, these two cast iron shelving units were over there somewhere, and I moved them over here. Now, you can't move them underneath this staircase in the regular game. And the reason for that is because the way Bethesda does their moving intelligence is it considers everything hovering over another thing as the top layer item. So if I were to select this and move it, you see how I can't put it down there? It's wanting to push it up there on top of the stairs. So I had to use my precise movement and rotating mod to... I placed the tables there, and then I pushed them under here with the mod. And then I had the daunting task of decorating them. I used OC Decorator to decorate each of these with kitchen utensils, kitchen items, foodstuffs, and then here's a larder. I put all of these different boxed foods, and I spent just a ton of time. And then I came to the bottom one, and I'm like, you know what? Screw it. I'm just going to put some Brahmin meat. I got lazy. I just put a big hunk of Brahmin meat down there. But because I couldn't use the actual workshop builder to place anything on it, I had to put it on the ground, use the precise movement mod to push it up there, put it on the ground, push it up there, put it on the ground, push it up there. That took a very long time. But I'm really happy with the result. You know, this little kitchen area is kind of cramped for space, so I wanted to make use of every inch that I could. And here's another lighthouse that came with this. Oh, wait, no, I put that lighthouse there. That's mine. Never mind. This corner was blown out, replaced it with these gray walls. These are the barn walls that came with the DLC. And then this kitchen was actually here. This top part of the kitchen is completely original. I didn't make any changes to it at all. Now this bottom one, there was an almost identical kitchen / sink area that I scrapped, and I replaced it with this one because this is a scavenging station, and if I assign a settler to it, it'll produce scrap, but it looks like the settler is washing dishes. You can tell it's slightly off. This is a tad more dingy than that one, but it's only slight, and I figure people won't notice unless I tell them on a video that I'm recording right now, you know? Not that I would ever do that. And then this came with the settlement. I liked it. It's tilted. And then I put some food and utensils and stuff on the wall. All right, now for the great beast of this settlement. I think I've used the word beast a lot in this. Moving on up to the attic, this was an absolute terror, a nightmare, a horror. This I converted into my den, and I'm really thrilled with the result. I'm just so pleased with how it turned out. I would want to hang out here. You know, I would love to live in this house. It's just so cool. So what I did is I put down some rugs to kind of make it a little bit more roomy, and I put some art on the wall. And for some reason, I didn't realize until this build that I could put a Mirelurk Queen claw on the wall. I guess I must have missed that in the workshop. So I saw that and I went, yes, perfect. That is going right here. And that went there, and then some Radstags went there. Here's a TV with a working holotape player. Let's turn something on. See, what should we watch? Let's watch some brainwashing commercials from the 1950s.
Pee Wee Reese has a way with Dodger rookies or sandlot youngsters. Pee Wee, you do a lot of work with boys.
Not work, Al.
Well, that's actually going to get loud, so let's take it off. But it is a working TV, and I'll turn that on when I leave. So over here, I've got a nice smoking station. I figure, you know what, if my character ever visits this, this is where she's going to go. She's going to sit in this chair. She's going to smoke her cigars, drink her whiskey, and watch some commercials from the 50s. That's what she's going to do. And then over here, I decorated this up really nice. I've got some fake magazines. These don't actually give you perks. They're just decorations. Some cigarettes, some coffee, a variety of different coffees. Black coffee and cappuccinos. Books, games, and there's a lot in here that was here originally. So that chest and that crate over there came with it. I have a mod that allows me to put these orange barriers, and I thought it looked great up here. So I put that orange barrier, I put that barrel, but these crates back there all came with it. I didn't move them at all. I put a candle on top. All of this came with it. You know, I figured this is an attic, so you're going to have file cabinets and boxes filled with paper. And this duffel bag, you know, you can't make duffel bags, so I went ahead and left it in there. And then just decorated with everything else that I thought was useful, including these little plants over here. Back over here, this is all original. I didn't move any of this. It looks like an attic. All I added were these nuclear material lamps and these tanned hides. Now, the reason I said this was nightmarish is because, as you can see, it's a gabled roof. It was intended to have this sloped roof, right? That's the original roof. But no matter how hard I tried, even using the precise movement and rotating mod, I couldn't get the ceiling tiles to bend and rotate downwards at a slope like I really wanted to. That forced me to kind of build an attic on top of this attic. But the problem is that it's oddly proportioned. So each of these tiles is, let's say, 2 cubic meters or whatever. So you've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. But then the actual width of it is like 15, so it's off by one. So I had to do a lot of finagling and cajiggering, and it ultimately led to this. I've got a little bitty gap, which I know is hard to see. I keep falling down the stairs. It's easier to see over here. So you see that? That's a gap in the wall that I had to patch, and it was just hellish to patch. Here, I'll tell you what. I'm going to hop on outside. That's going to make it easier to show you everything that I had to do to patch this wall. Okay, so I ended up building this on top of here. And then the roof, I used these sort of gabled roofs that came with the DLC. None of this snapped, ladies and gentlemen. None of it snapped. I had to use the precise rotating and movement tool to get all of that in there. And then you see how they just didn't fit together? There was this crack right here. And I had to use, this is a floor, this is a barn floor, which I used the precise rotating and movement mod to kind of twist downward because it's normally flat. And then I filled this little corner with just a little shack piece, and the same over here. That's how I managed to get it done. Looks like it's getting dark. Let's change the time of day. And then I just stuck this roof cupola on the very top, and it turned out pretty well. So that was the main house. Here you can see a closer detail on the roof repairs that I did. You see that I just put those roof tiles down flat and then used these balcony railings, shoved them up against the side to kind of make a flush seam. It was just a lot of work and sweat and heartache, but it turned out perfectly. I couldn't be happier with the way the inside turned out. So there you go. That is the primary residence for these settlers. That's where they go at the end of every day to sleep. But there is a whole lot more settlement to show off. So moving on over here, I want to show off this workshop. So there was an original workshop that came with the settlement, and I liked the look of it. It was open to the elements. It had a nice pillar down the middle of it. But it was broken and cracked and crumbling to pieces. And I didn't want that. I wanted to make it nice. So, the nice thing that Bethesda did is they allowed us to scrap pre-existing buildings. So I scrapped it and then tried to recreate it as best as I could using the barn textures. And this is the result that I have. I used the pillars, the posts that came with the DLC 3, Far Harbor, here in the middle there. And this is the perfect use for these particular cage wall lights, which came with Wasteland Workshop. They look great in a workshop environment. And I built this thing up, so I did use mods to try and get this to work. I had to use the precise movement and rotating mod to get all of the pieces in there perfectly. For some of it, but for most of it, it went down just fine. I placed a platform down here. This is a new cement platform. Now you can see this is the original wall of the building. So the original shack ended like right around here, but I wanted to extend it to include the workshop, because what kind of shack doesn't include the workshop? So I made it deeper. It has a lot more room and had plenty of room for my fusion generator. I have some of these workbenches up here. These workbenches are unique. They come with certain mods. This workbench is really cool. It's even got a mannequin smoking a cigar. It comes with an armor and weapons keyword mod that I have installed. It's basically a central source for you to be able to craft all of the custom outfits you download with mods. And this weapon workbench just looks really great. It's got weapons decorated on it. It's got a, you know, all sorts of stuff over here. It just looks wonderful. So I added it down. Not that I'm going to use them. This is also where I have my terminal. The terminal is what I use to access the settlement management software. This is a scavenging station, rejiggered to look like a workshop shop shelf. And then this little, I don't know what it is. Let's see, what is it that the game calls this thing? It's like a garage meter. Garage diagnostic chart. This garage diagnostic chart is a cart is one of two that you found in the basement of the main house. And you can't move it, and you can't do anything but scrap it. But I like the look of it. I just wanted it to fit in my workshop. So I used the precise movement and rotating tool to move this up here to the workshop, just as sort of like a set decoration. I then put up this this loft area up there, and I filled it with all sorts of boxes and crates because I figure, you know what, they're going to be using this for storage. So let's move on over here. This building was a complete mess. It was crumpled in, walls were gone. It was just basically splinters of wood. So I scrapped what was here originally, and I decided to replace it with a communal shower slash bathroom. So let's move on in. I'm using these chemical showers, which came with a pool mod that I have installed. I did a video review of it in the past. It's linked in the description. And it is usable. Your character and the settlers can come up and use the shower. I then used a bathroom decorations mod to decorate up the inside of this. I've got soap on the walls, towels on the walls, cups filled with toothbrushes and toothpaste. All the way around. So this is the communal shower place. I've got towels stacked over here so that they can dry themselves. And then I figured that one bathroom in the main house was just not enough for 36 settlers. So I used what resources I had to build these bathroom stalls. I used these pieces that came with the vanilla Fallout 4 as stall separators. And I've got some mini potted plants for decoration. I've got toilet paper on the side here so that you can actually use toilet paper for your toilet, which is great. Some decorated shelves up here, some decorated shelves over here. And the same with this side over here. Just a lot of different stalls, decorated up to look really nice, toilet paper, towels, all sorts of decorations. So there you go. I've got it well lit on the inside here, and settlers can use it. It's perfectly functional. So there is my communal bathroom. That's what I decided to use that building for. Now, in the spirit of keeping what you don't need to scrap, I kept all the logs out here and the pallets. I even kept this piece of machinery just because I liked the look of it. It looked like it fitted in, and it was being piloted by a gnome. You see that? I just thought that was too cool to scrap. So I left it, and I love it. Now, I'm really proud of this. So this building was, again, a complete mess, and I recreated it. But before I... Well, here, I'll show you what I did. So you see this conveyor belt? The conveyor belt originally went out these barn doors, which were not barn doors. This used to have a conveyor that went all the way down to the water, and it was filled with logs, and I guess, you know, this was just where they processed logs, maybe skinned the bark off of them, and then sent them out into the water to start a log jam. Well, what I did is I scrapped the structure that was on top of this platform. These are the original wooden platforms that came with this structure. I then scrapped the conveyor part of this belt, and I left this part of it because I figured this could be the community dining area. It's the perfect height for a table, chairs fit under it perfectly, and it's already set up and it's keeping in with the aesthetic feel of a lumber mill. I thought it was just too good to scrap, so I left them and I worked it into the design. I built around it. So I've got foodstuffs all set out. I've got plates decorated with food. By the way, every single plate has a different meal on it. I'm not even kidding. I have been cooking food for the longest time, and so I've got tons of food saved up, and every single meal is completely unique. Even soup. I haven't had a good close look at that soup yet. That looks interesting. There's one thing that I'm a little upset with. You see how there's this sort of muddy grass texture on the floor? That is some sort of decal or overlay that you can't get rid of with console commands, no matter what you do. In fact, it's so bad that anything you place on top of a section of your floor that has something like this on it will get it on it as well. And it's true over here. It stretches over here. So some of the food has all of this guck on it, which is just, it's regrettable. But you know what? It's a post-apocalypse. If you're going to be concerned about eating a little bit of mud with your meal, well, I'm sure there are worse things to think about. I decorated the walls up to have make use of the big posters. So the huge posters that came with my poster mod, I normally don't get to use just because walls are never that tall. But the walls in the barn tiles are that tall, so I got to use my very large posters, and then I just put some food posters on the wall. Lots of lighting on the inside, and of course these wonderful barn doors that can open up to give people a view of the water or to let in some light. Or radioactive fog, depending on which you're wanting that day. This dock came with it. I didn't have to build that. Then leaving this area, the dock continues on. I decided to leave these shipping containers. There were a bunch more that were tipped on their sides and sort of falling out over here. I scrapped those because they didn't look safe and they looked like they were nasty. But I left these. I didn't actually do anything with them. I'm trying to think of something maybe I could do with them. And then I left these logs over here. But coming on down, here's the primary waterside dock. And I decided to turn it into a bit of a lounge area. Let's change the weather really quick. I do have my water purifiers down there, so since this is by the water, I figured I wouldn't use the concrete ones. I would just put the ones that actually go in the water, make use of the water that I have. And then up here I put a table with some drinks and soup and candles. I've got a grilling station, so this is a new fish grill that came with Far Harbor. I set that down there on the dock, some fish that the settlers have caught, a barrel on fire. This crane came with the settlement, and again, another set piece that's just too good to scrap. Can't find it any other way, so I left it. And then around the corner, I've got a random lobster trap and a smoking station, complete with cigarette machine. That's right, if you put containers in your settlements, they do refill over time, especially if you have the scrounger perk. So, great way to farm packs of cigarettes. Cigars, lit cigarettes, all sorts of goodness. Man, the weather changes really quickly in this DLC. All right, so that's the bulk of the buildings. Now there's still more to show you. This is a huge, huge settlement. Here's a fog condenser. By the way, I just realized this. I don't know why I didn't realize it's now, but you can actually go to fog condensers and you can loot condensed fog. You guys probably already knew that. I'm just late to the game, so. All right, moving through the workshop, we come to this area, and I struggled with this for a long time. I had everything else built. Everything else was done. And I sat here looking at this going, what could this be? What could I do with this? I couldn't think of anything to do with it. Now, I tell you what I wanted to do. I wanted to have a sort of outdoor leisure area because I wanted to find a way to save this log in the middle here. So as we saw at the beginning of this video, the lumber games were going on. And so here's one of the lumber games. This is a log sitting in the middle of the settlement, and they were doing some cutting. So here's a saw, a lumberjack saw in the middle of this log. And I'm sure they were having contests on who could cut through the log the fastest. And then here's a post over here with random saw cuts in it. And you can see the saws in the actual log. I actually had to replace those because they kept falling out. So I used my OC Decorator mod to place those back in there. So this was like an activity area, and this was the gallery. This area right here is where the spectators would sit and watch the games going on. So I tried to re-envision this as an activity slash lounge area. Now I did make a mistake, and I'll tell you, let's see, this, I wanted it to be a covered area because I wanted it to be well lit, protected from the elements so that I could have things like pool tables. I mean, you can't have a pool table out in the elements. It would get soggy and nasty and, you know, it just wouldn't work. So I wanted it to be a covered area. And I built this, what I thought was a pretty unique structure, and it turned out pretty well. Now, I did end up using these pillars that came with a different mod, which I have linked in the description, because the pillars that come with the Far Harbor barn tiles, they just don't work well. They can only be built from the ground up, not from the ceiling down. And that's the reversed way that you want to build it, right? The way you should build it is you have a ceiling already, and you don't want your posts to clip through the ceiling, and you're not going to know how many posts you need until you start building, right? So if you go from the ground up, obviously the bottom of your post is standing firmly on the ground, and you go 1, 2, 3, but then you get to the top and you find out that the post you have is longer than the gap between the end of the last post and the top of the structure, and so you end up getting this pillar that sticks out of your structure, which just does not look good. The mod, however, allows you to build from the top down, so you can stick the pillar to the top, to the ceiling that you're trying to build a pillar on, and then just start building down, and then the pillar will clip through the ground, which no one ever sees, so it's not that big of a deal. So this is just an odd instance where a modder had the foresight to design pillars in a better way than Bethesda did. Yeah, it's just kind of funny that way. I also didn't want to place a floor down here. Obviously, what I might have done in a previous build is place a floor. I didn't want to do that here for a couple of reasons. Number one, the pre-existing things. Like this log that was pre-existing, I would have only have been able to move it with a mod. And sadly, you can only move the log itself. These support struts, if you scrap the log, they disappear, and you can't actually select them to remove them. So it was either on the ground or nothing. And number two, I didn't want to obscure the look of the view of the water. Right? You've got this nice view of the water down here, and if I had built this level structure, it would have completely blocked off the view of the water. So that's why I decided to make it an open-air marketplace slash lounge area, and yet that did come with its own difficulties in that these shops would have hovered on the ground because it's built on a slope, and you can't place something flat like this on the ground without it hovering. So I did have to build a unique platform for each of my different shops. I finish off my 17 bars in here, but then I also add a general shop, a clothing shop, and a clinic, just to sort of round out the marketplace feel to it. By the way, I'm using a tier 2 level clothing shop because I discovered after I finished my happiness experiment that the tier 2 shop for the clothing shop only generates exactly the same amount of happiness as the tier 3 clothing shop. It's cheaper, it has a different look from all of the other shops, so I figured I'd use a tier 2 shop. But the mistake that I made is that I made the ceiling way too tall. So I made the ceiling way up there, I gave it plenty of space, it's got this sort of vaulted feel to it, and then I wired the ceiling with electricity, it's piped in through this lamp over here, but I discovered when night fell that light generated from these lights, it doesn't go all the way to the ground. It goes all about halfway down and then it stops, which means that you've got the roof of this thing completely illuminated at night, but then the ground is not illuminated at all. So my mistake was that I made this too tall. I should have made the canopy much shorter. But I tried to get around this by placing these lamps right here. For some reason, the caged lamp would not stick to these posts, which was really frustrating. So I used this workshop lamp that came with vanilla Fallout 4, and then I also decorated with candles and fire barrels and other sources of light as I found it necessary just to illuminate things on the ground here. I found it really tricky to try and keep this pool table illuminated, so I actually installed this construction light, wired it to this lamppost over there, and that helps keep it lit at night. I used OC Decorator to decorate this with billiard balls and billiard cues. And then over here, I figure cutting this log is going to be a test of strength. You're going to have the mightiest men in the Commonwealth coming to test their might against each other. And so I also made a little workout area where I've got some barbells and some 10-pound weights and 5-pound weights. You know, I figure they're going to be like, we He-Man, Muscle Men, we're going to do exercises. Then around here, I've got a cigarette machine with some candles on it just to kind of contribute to the loungy feel of things. And then over here, I really liked this sort of log bridge. I didn't want to jump on the logs to move them. I didn't want to wreck this beautiful little perfect line of logs that for some reason has lasted 200 years after the apocalypse. But it has, and I didn't want to ruin it. So I didn't touch it. I didn't scrap the logs. I left that completely alone. All I did is I took this little dock area and I turned it into an ice lounge. I've got a fish grilling station right there on the corner, complete with a fire barrel, and then a smoking station with beer and cigarettes. Over here, I've got some hanging fish and this little troglodyte thing, whatever that is. Trilobite. Now, let's talk defense. One more thing. I am actually really bummed that I was unable to scrap this. I don't understand why Bethesda would allow us to scrap the blown out buildings over there, but not this hideous monstrosity which is taking up space. If you could use it, like if you could somehow use console commands to get rid of this filth and then rebuild the benches, that would be one thing. Then I would be pleased to have it, and I would have worked on it. But you can't get rid of the filth, unlike filth found elsewhere, and you can't scrap these benches to build more benches on top of it. So it's really just this hunk of cement and wood that is taking up a huge amount of real estate that your settlers won't use, you can't use, and it has no purpose being there. So that was a little disappointing. But anyway, let's talk defense. So let's go to our settlement management mod and let's mark all of the enemy spawn points in this settlement. All right, so looking at our compass, we see that there's only one marker on the map. What? How could it be? Such a large settlement and only one attack spawn point? But you know what, ladies and gentlemen? That's the reality. Out here on the road is the only spawn point for this settlement. Dalton Farms has 2 spawn points, the Visitor Center has 3 spawn points, but Echo Lake Lumber Mill, one of the largest settlements in the DLC, has only one spawn point, and it's right there. So I built this elevated tower structure right on the edge of this erstwhile unused building. I placed these platforms down there to make a level structure for my turrets. Oh, looks like we've got the light glitch again. There we go. The light actually works now. And then I placed some balcony supports underneath it so that it looks like it's built into the structure. I figure we could pretend like they just built this right on top of the building. I've got a ballistic machine gun turret, 2 missile turrets, 2 heavy laser turrets, this spotlight, and then eventually these 2 guards. Once I get enough settlers, I'll be able to put guards there. And then this dog actually has 2 more defense than your regular junkyard dog. Gracie gives you 10 defense. So that brings my defense to a whopping 78 right now. When I get my 2 more guards, that's going to bump me up to 82. So my defense for the settlement is going to be 82, which is perfect from a happiness perspective. From a happiness perspective, you just need to have 1 defense for every 1 settler. The rule of thumb used to be that you add your food to your water, and that's the amount of defense that you have to have. But I've found through my experimentations that from a happiness perspective, at least, that's not true. And you actually don't get a reduced chance of being attacked Once your defense matches your settlement population. So, I'm keeping it fairly minimal here. That said, I do want my defenses to do the work for me, so when I come into a settlement, I don't want to have to be constantly killing everything. So, I did put quite a lot of defenses up here, and that should be perfectly sufficient to protect my settlement. The only thing left to do is show you how this settlement looks at night. So I've set the hour to be at night. You can see that the lights work really well illuminating the Echo Lake Lumber sign. Moving on in, and it looks alive. It looks lived in. I've got these lights underneath each of these different umbrella stations here. I've got lights underneath each of the different bars. I've got these burning barrels. Each of the buildings looks very well illuminated. Going on into the house, and you can see that even in the middle of the dark night, it's 2 in the morning right now, it's illuminated. Whoa. Well.
Now that's some firepower there.
They're using their beds, plenty of light. You can see every nook and cranny. This corner is a little dark, but aside from that, coming around the corner, it's all lit up really well. It was tricky to get all of this lighting to work due to the sheer size of this particular structure. It's just so large that there are a couple of dead places throughout the house. But for the most part, it worked really well. I have these lamp posts decorating the settlement. I decided to use a different lamp post style for each settlement that I build. I've used the other two already. This was the last one, so I used this lamp style for this settlement. I've got them decorating, illuminating this area. There is a glitch with this particular lamp post, though, and that's that the light casts on the wrong side. So look, the lamppost is facing out there, and you would expect this corner to be illuminated, but it's not. It's back here that's illuminated. So the actual light emits on the wrong side of these lampposts. That's just a Wasteland Workshop glitch, and not much you can do about that. And then here is my activity area, and as you can see, look at the ground in comparison to the ceiling. The ceiling is completely well lit because I've got all those lights up there, but the ground has all of these patches of light, and that's because the light from the ceiling doesn't actually hit the ground. It sort of stops halfway going down. So I had to go through and place all of these other lights closer to the ground to try and add some luminosity to this little area. As you can see, candles actually help a lot. For some reason, candles emit quite a lot of light. The spotlight does help illuminate the table just a little bit, but it is not perfect, but it helps. And then I've got some barrels for fire out here. I like these little sort of lonely smoking nooks because they're only illuminated by firelight, and it just makes them look really atmospheric. Let's pop into the sky and take a look. And there we go. This is my Echo Lake Lumber Mill huge settlement. A huge, huge, huge job, but ultimately very, very rewarding. I had so much fun putting it together. I'm super pleased with the result. And this was a highly requested video. Many of you asked me over and over again in the comments section of my other videos, please do Echo Lake Lumber Mill. I have no idea what I'm going to do with Echo Lake Lumber Mill. Please give me your ideas for Echo Lake Lumber Mill. Well, there you go, ladies and gentlemen. This is Oxhorn's Echo Lake Lumber Mill. I would love to hear your feedback in the comments. Again, I didn't want to do anything too fancy. Everything looks like it would actually work. I tried to keep up with the spirit of the original build, to reuse things as I found them, and just make it look like a lived-in structure. This settlement only has 10 settlers so far because it's brand new, but as it grows, these bars will be used, the beds will be assigned, and it will really start to catch some life. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching this latest efficiency settlement build. Please subscribe to me here on YouTube for more efficiency settlement builds. I only have a few more settlements to go and then I've got them all done. But never fear, even when I've got them all done, I have a few ideas to revisit the ones that I've done in the past. And I have a plan to download some mods that open up new areas to be settlements, and I can work on building some of those. Additionally, I produce a lot of other Fallout 4 content, including walkthroughs of quests, side quests, overviews of legendary modifications, and so on and so forth. So please subscribe for more Fallout 4 content. I would love to hear your feedback in the comment section of this video, so please leave a comment, and thank you again so much for watching.